interesting solutions that are pushing the food industry forward. I would like to say welcome to Edward Hall from BioExtracts and Henrik Thuresson from WaterSprint. Are you with me?
Yes, hello.
Hi. So I know you're doing good stuff. Can you start, Henrik Thuresson, by telling us a little bit, what does WaterSprint do?
Yes, of course. So WaterSprint is an innovation company. Actually, we were founded in 2013, where the technique edge on a new way of purifying water with a technique called UVC LED. So you could say instead of using large traditional UV lights and bulbs, we use very small LED diodes. And by doing so, we can have a really small footprint on our units, and you can fit them in a lot of different places where it wasn't possible before. And also, since it's LED,
for example, what could that be, for example?
So, for example, in showers, taps, water dispensers, boats.
Interesting.
There are some issues that we don't talk very much about regarding viruses and bacteria. For example, we have E. coli and we have Legionella, or Legionnaires' disease. Things that actually are popping up a little bit more now due to that the society is opening up again from the lockdown. So.
And who do you offer this to today? Who do you sell to?
Do you mean specific companies or segments or?
Both.
Okay,
I wonder about the segment.
Okay. So the segments, like I said, so it's for example hospitals. In hospitals, obviously, you have sick people and with a decreased immune system. And when you have a decreased immune system, you're more vulnerable for other diseases, which can come from, for example, Legionella. So,
have you been able to sort of... Sorry, Henrik. It's difficult when we're not close to each other. But
yeah.
So how long have you sort of come within sort of leaching out or reaching out with your invention? Is it common now that people use it? Do they know about it, or where are you at?
So actually, I'm very new at WaterSprint. I've been here for 2 months, and since I started here, we have had actually a lot of requests. So now I really realize it sounds like hospitals is the only segment, but that was just an example. We've been contacted by water dispenser producers. We've been contacted by boat suppliers, boat producers. The thing with our units and this invention is that you can fit it almost anywhere because it's this big. I mean, it's...
And what would you need to accelerate?
Good question. At the moment, we're working on the marketing material so that we can communicate to the market what we're actually doing in an easy way.
A very good start. I work with communication. It's a very good start that people know what you're doing, Henrik.
Exactly. I agree. Totally agree.
So I will also ask you, Edward, can you tell us a little about BioExtracts?
Sure. Thank you. It's my favorite topic. So BioExtracts, we're a company doing microbiology or industrial biotechnology. So that means that we're using bacteria, non-GMO bacteria, I should mention, in different industrial processes. And we produce a number of different things using bacteria only. So that is the core thing. So The main part of our business is to develop technologies around the production of a certain kind of polymer called PHA, or polyhydroxyalkanoates. This is a bio-based, meaning that it's made from renewable or, well, green content, and it's also biodegradable polymer. And an interesting aspect from a food or feed perspective is that the unique feature about our technology to produce this kind of polymer, this kind of biopolymer, is that we get a co-product from the production, which is a hydrolyzed single cell protein. So this is a kind of material with around 60% protein, which is highly digestible and so on, and can be used as food or feed. I actually ate some of it yesterday. Which I shouldn't recommend yet, because we don't have all the certifications. But you know, if not me, then
so who? you might turn into a pumpkin now. Or
yes, and so that is the first part of our technology, a method to produce this biopolymer, and we generate a co-product, which is a protein ingredient. And then we also have a technology to hydrolyze feathers or break down feathers. So this is poultry feathers from chicken and turkey. And what we do is basically that we use bacteria, which releases enzymes, and these enzymes, they break down the feathers. And what we get on the other side is a hydrolyzed protein. So basically the keratin in the feathers, which is around 90% of the feathers, is broken down into amino acids, which can be used again as feed or food. It's not as tasty as the bacterial or kind of the co-product from the biopolymer. It has kind of a it's a bit sour, but it has a very high protein content of more than 90%.
So what stage are you at? Have you sort of reached, sort of, are you on the market, or you're still in the research phase, or?
Yeah, so we have we adopt a licensing model primarily, which means that we're not producing anything ourselves. We are licensing it to other producers. So, for instance, a rendering company, so somebody who currently are buying feathers and doing stuff with it, they can license our technology or and so on. And we have our first commercial kind of agreement in place since around 2 months with an American company, and that's for the biopolymer application. And hopefully we will add a few more of those in the coming weeks and months. We also have a pilot running here in Lund, at Ideon in Lund, where we can produce on a kilogram scale, but that's only for demonstration purposes and also to sell samples.
So what do you hope for? You hope that someone that could do great things together with you would use this, or how does the sort of business model look for you?
The business model is fairly simple. It's a pretty classical licensing model where let's say as I mentioned, a rendering company, or it could also be a sugar company. So as you may or may not know, that the sugar industry is struggling quite a lot with dipping prices and dipping demand, and you can turn sugar into this biopolymer, which is, and you know, on the other hand, something that the world is lacking quite a lot. So then we can license our whole technology from sugar to biopolymer, which can go into packaging and so on. And then hopefully they pay us a kind of yearly license and then a royalty per kilogram produced as well. But we are not the only, I should highlight that we're not the only technology to produce this biopolymer, but we are by far the cheapest.
Oh, so you have one ASP. But what would you need now to sort of to get running better or sort of get out there more?
Staff is we need more more personnel or a bigger team, because we have a lot to do, and it's really, really hard to find people with kind of cutting edge expertise.
The right competence, or is it, or do you need investments to hire, or?
No, both? The right competence. We are pretty well funded at the moment.
Okay. Mm. Well, sounds really interesting. How can both of your sort of inventions change the world as you see it? Can you sort of do you have a dream on what will happen if your inventions get out there more?
So our goal is to offer safe water for everyone. So pretty easy.
And you have started off here in Sweden, or do you have? Have you sort of gone outside Sweden?
We're in the we offer it to all over the globe, but at the moment we have business in Australia, England, Sweden, Norway, Denmark, South Africa. So it's growing pretty good.
And what about you, Edward?
Yeah, I mean, our kind of offering to the planet is fairly simple in a way. There are two things. First of all, it's a kind of a sustainable and cost-efficient method to produce a bio-based and biodegradable polymer, basically replacing fossil-based plastics, which is good both in terms of CO2 emissions, but also in terms of plastic pollution. So that one is pretty simple. But then we also have the co-product from the biopolymer production, which can replace fish meal and soy meal and so on, which comes with their own issues. And similarly with the hydrolyzed feathers that can be used for feed, it's also a way to replace, in particular, fish meal, because it has a fairly similar amino acid profile.
Do you have anyone that you want to meet in the mingle later on?
Yes, I'm sure. I haven't looked, in the attendee list I can only see names and I don't know where everyone comes from. But I'm very interested in general to speak to people who are buyers or users of protein. We have quite a lot of companies who are looking for our biopolymers, and we kind of know what the market wants, but in our two protein products are very unique, there is no existing market.
Perfect, you got that out. And Henrik, is there anyone that you would like to meet out there in the mingle later?
Yes, but I haven't looked at the list very much either. But so what I'm interested in is of course anyone who would like to purify their water. But if I should mention something, someone working with the real estate or properties where you have Legionnaires' disease problems or you want to avoid it. And I know this is something that we don't want to talk about, so I get it. But perhaps you can contact me directly and we will keep it a secret.
They don't have to tell the whole world. They can just tell you. But and I think it's really interesting what you're saying, because perhaps I know we have a great network or a great list of people that have registered for today's conference. But I think that there are also people out there that don't know that it could be really interesting to mingle with you. And I think that's what we're going to have to work with. So get more people into this network. We're from different areas. And I think that's how we will kickstart the Southern Sweden food innovation scene. Super. Thank you.